that moment at Thanksgiving when you bring out the beautiful cooked turkey and everyone oohs and ahs. Well, today we have another main course that can be just as impressive and might end up on your table this Thanksgiving. Preparing his crab-stuffed salmon with a cranberry glaze, please welcome back amazing chef Andrew Gruhl. Welcome back, Andrew.
Well, thank you for having me back. I appreciate
it. You're very impressive.
I'll get out of town.
Take a look at Cameron and Kim and Orly's plate.
It's like a work of art.
This would be my centerpiece.
That, you know,
it really would.
Yeah. Throw a little seafood in there for the holiday table. Why not? Omega-3s, get smarter.
Thank you for understanding.
Okay, so you guys dig in. This is a great alternative for anyone who might just not want to have turkey again this year, right?
Yeah, that tryptophan can get intense. So if you want to stay awake a little bit later, catch some of those holiday specials, I recommend salmon.
And it's very impressive, yet it's not as difficult to make as impressive as it looks impressive. You know what I'm trying to say.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
It's simple.
I'd like you to try again, Deb, please.
It's not as difficult to make as... No, I'm going to try again. It's not going to work. Okay, so we start with the stuffing.
Yeah, so we start with the stuffing, which is just going to be a crab stuffing. And whatever's left over here, the fun part about the holidays are the leftovers, right? So whatever's left over, you can use for crab cakes as well. We just did a touch of mayo, a little bit of lemon juice in here, lemon zest. You get that beautiful lemon citrusy flavor with all those oils. Sriracha, which is, of course, the obligatory spice with flavor. Worcestershire sauce, soy sauce. And there's going to be a quiz on this afterwards.
This sounds so good.
Dijon mustard.
These flavors are phenomenal.
A little bit of panko breadcrumb, which really nice crunch, and it kind of soaks up some of that stuffing there. Chives.
Now, could you do this with shrimp if you didn't have crab?
Oh, yeah, you could do this with shrimp. You could flake some smoked fish in here. I mean, this really is a base, a foundation upon which you can, heck, you could even do chicken in here in theory, right? It's all about the... It's all about the filling, right? So I added some green apple there at the end, which is somewhat untraditional, but the tartness of that green apple really cuts through the richness of both the salmon and the crab. So it's a nice addition, somewhat of a secret ingredient, if you will.
Will it stay crunchy?
It'll stay crunchy, really because we're cooking the outside first, so it'll melt into it a little bit, but still maintain that texture, which is partially why we want to leave the skin on the outside.
Okay.
So the idea here is you want to keep the chunks, you know, intact, but kind of mix this all together.
And the crab's already cooked.
The crab is already cooked, you know, and all the other ingredients are just melding into this. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna let this sit for just a sec. Okay. We've got our salmon, which why not just throw it right here in the center so that we can kind of move from there. Now what I've done is I butterflied the salmon, and this is just a side, pin bones out, skin off. You can pick this up at the butcher shop. Really simple, most all grocery stores have it. And if you don't want to cut this open in your own house, you can just have the fishmonger do it yourself.
Okay, easy.
So,
is there a certain size salmon you would ask for?
Yeah, I assume, especially in this case, because we're stuffing it, maybe 6 ounces per person.
Okay.
So a typical side is 2 to 3 pounds.
Okay.
So depending on how many people you can have the whole side.
Okay, beautiful.
So what we're going to do here is we're actually going to just lay some of this this crab stuffing right along the inside of the salmon.
And it's probably important not to overstuff, right?
Yeah, very important not to overstuff both the salmon and yourself.
You might overstuff yourself with this because it's so good. It looks so fancy, but it really is so easy to make.
That's the idea. I mean, that's how I've been making my way through the industry for so many years. That's my trick.
Sorry, Andrew, how many servings are you making in that one roll right there?
In this roll right here, we can cut 2 to 3 medallions.
I was curious. Is that just for me, or are we getting some other people as well?
So good.
Roll it up and throw it on a sandwich for one. There we go. So we added some asparagus on the inside that's going to add both color, and then what a great way to eat your veggies without having to have it on the outside of the plate.
Raw asparagus?
This is lightly blanched. So we just cooked it for about 20, 30 seconds in boiling water. Shock it either in the refrigerator or ice water.
Sure.
And then there you go.
Okay.
So what we're going to do here is we're just going to roll this like a pin roll, right?
So, look at that.
And the key was, you see how I left the 3/4 of the top empty? Because it's going to kind of roll into that. So
giant sushi roll.
I was just about to say that.
Yeah, exactly.
If you put crispy rice on that, I would go crazy.
We could just stop right here, right? You know, just kind of go for it at that.
Oh, you got to close it up though, right?
No, I'm just
kidding.
Okay. He was going to bite it.
So I'm just going to give this a couple ties across the top here, and nothing complicated. We don't need to be trussing or doing any fancy bows on this. This is just to kind of hold it together
so that we can. So it doesn't all fall
out. Exactly.
So as you're tying that up, how do you know when the salmon is cooked with it all rolled up like that?
Good question.
sell?
Yeah, great question. So it's hard enough for salmon alone without it being tied up. The idea behind this one is what you want to do is you want to take a fork after about 20 minutes at 350 degrees and press on the salmon. And if it immediately just starts to flake down to the stuffing and you can see it in there, then you know it's done.
Good to know.
If you want to get fancy, you can take a cake tester, put it all the way through the salmon, hold it for about 3 seconds, and then put it to your bottom lip. And if it's warm, you also know that the inside is done and cooked.
That is too fancy.
Yeah, that's real fancy. Okay, so now we put this on a...
Yep.
Just put it... Oh,
so, well, first thing we're going to do is we're going to cut this into medallions, okay? See?
Oh,
so
you're going to cut it before you cook.
We're going to... Exactly, because otherwise it'll just fall right apart.
Okay, good to know.
So we've got that right there.
Place that on our baking sheet and pop that in the oven. How long would this go in the oven?
So about 20 minutes right there, okay? And then we're just going to season this as well. You can hit it with just, since my hands are dirty.
I will do that. You can come over here and wash your hands.
Hit that with just a little salt and pepper.
And Andrew, it's okay to obviously have it sort of resting upwards like that and also have some on the side. It doesn't make a difference.
Exactly, because what's going to happen is that once it roasts and all those flavors start to melt in there, doesn't matter what side it's on, it's gonna be delicious regardless.
Okay. So we got, oh my gosh, it's beautiful, Andrew. Look at that.
Good work, Dad.
Wow, thank you. I worked very hard
magic,
on it.
Magic. So as you see here as well, a little bit of this white that's coming out, that's the albumin, so you also know the salmon is cooked at that point.
That's what I thought you were gonna say.
Yep.
I
was talking about.
So we could stop here, but why when you have this beautiful cranberry glaze that you like to spoon over top of
it? The holidays are always about the sauce. So what we've done is that we made a bourbon cranberry glaze here. So we just started off, it's a one pot dish where you throw in a little bit of bourbon, orange juice, cranberry, sugar, red wine vinegar, cinnamon, and some fresh thyme. And it's got this kind of rich, unctuous tartness that goes really well with the salmon. Typically, people think berries, is that too sweet for the salmon? But it's very, very tart, so it cuts through the richness of the salmon. You've got those really, really rich omega-3 fatty acids in there. And
let me take that off.
Yep.
So I don't eat the string.
That's perfect. So we call that the salmon bikini right there.
Oh,
I should maybe look away or something. What's happening? I don't know. Go ahead. You take off the bikini.
I always cover up my kids' eyes during this process.
Andrew, go ahead and serve that up. Absolutely delicious.
Wow. Here you go, Andrew.
Happy holidays, everybody. To learn more about Andrew's adventures online, follow him at Andrew Gruhl, and make sure to visit HallmarkChannel.com to grab this recipe, everybody.